I'm here for other children. I'm here because I care. I'm here because children everywhere are suffering, and because 40,000 people die each day from hunger. I'm here because those people are mostly children. We have got to understand that the poor are all around us and we're ignoring them. We have got to understand that these deaths are preventable. We have got to understand that people in third world countries think and care and smile and cry just like us. We have got to understand that they are us. We are them. My dream is to stop hunger by the year 2000. My dream is to give the poor a chance. My dream is to save the 40,000 people who die each day. My dream can and will come true if we all look into the future and see the light that shines there.
A 23-year-old American activist stands in front of an Israeli bulldozer in Gaza.
Rachel Corey, a 23-year-old American student, went to Gaza to join in these efforts, sending back emails to her parents.
I have been in Palestine for 2 weeks and 1 hour now, and I still have very few words to describe what I see. It is most difficult for me to think about what's going on here when I sit down to write back to the United States. Something about the virtual portal into luxury. I don't know if many of the children here have ever existed without tank shell holes in their walls and the towers of an occupying army surveying them constantly from the near horizons. I think, although I'm not entirely sure, that even the smallest of these children understand that life is not like this everywhere.
It was Sunday afternoon in Charlotte, about noon actually, and I received a phone call. And my son-in-law, Kelly, was on the phone, and he asked if Craig was there. And something about the way he asked made me realize, I felt right away that something was wrong. And then I asked, why Kelly? And he hesitated for a minute, and he said, we've had some very sad news. And then my daughter, Sarah, I could hear her in the background. And she got on the telephone and she said, Mom, it's Rachel. And I think the first words out of my mouth then were, is she dead?
Opposing the demolition of farmland and other property, Palestinian property by Israeli destruction forces and bulldozers. The bulldozer drove up, and it kept going, and she tried to move back, but she couldn't move back, and she got caught underneath. She got caught underneath the bulldozer. Many other internationals began to surround the bulldozer and yell at it and tell it that there's somebody there, and it did not stop.
Where Rachel was killed, she was protecting a doctor's home. And that's important to realize. And the three children, his wife, she knew that family, and that doctor felt that Rachel was like a daughter to him. He bought that house. It was in the middle of the neighborhood. There were other rows of houses between his house and the border. Those other homes, those other streets were all destroyed, and now it was his turn. And I've had people say, well, she was in a war zone. And Cindy points out that war zone is people's neighborhoods. Those are children.
Parents are proud of what their daughter did, recalling how important it was to her to try and help Palestinian families in Gaza.
There are just countless ways in which these children are experiencing incredibly difficult things, and I want to support them.